Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1908, Data Cleansing with the Sequencer. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. After yesterday's podcast, 1907, I got several great suggestions. And this first one is from Jim Simons. Jim was in one of my Excel VBA classes at the University of Akron many years ago and said that frequently he gets data in from a PDF file that is just ugly. You know, the report titles are repeated on every row, and he has to go through a lot of data cleansing. And he wrote a little macro to help with this. Of course, we have to get rid of all those report titles, and it would be really tedious to go through and just delete them one at a time. We want to sort that data. But after we sort the data, we need to get the data back into the original sequence. And so the first thing we want to do is add a sequence column over here to show the original sequence. But there's no good way to do this because of the gaps in the data. Even if I double click here, it only fills down to where the gap occurs, and then you know we'd have to drag down everything like that. So I'm going to delete that column. Jim wrote this great little macro. He calls it the sequencer, and he assigned it to a keyboard shortcut of Control-Shift-S. What it does is it inserts a brand new column A to the left of the data, finds where the last row is in any of the columns, irrespective of the gaps, and then adds the sequence numbers from 1 to that last row used. Let's go take a look at the code. It's very simple code. Yeah. So the last cell row, he uses special cells, Excel last cell. This is like pressing Control End in the keyboard and figures out what row that is. And then he inserts a new column 1, column A, puts the number 1 up in cells 1, 1, that's cell A1, and selects that. That allows him to do selection.autofill, which is kind of like what I did, but we're going to say the destination is not just to the next gap, but we're going to go from the active cell, that's cell A1. We're going to resize down to the last cell row. That's this variable that he created up here, comma 1, and the type is XL fill series. So let's take a look at how this simplifies things. Here's that report. Just choose any cell, Control-Shift-S, and we get the brand new column over on the left-hand side. We can now go over to column B and just do data A to Z, and now that brings all of those report titles together. They're going to be down there in the My Report Title, and actually I don't need the report title at all, so I'm going to delete all of those rows, Alt-E-D-R, Enter, and then I'm going to leave the first set of headings there and delete the rest of them, Alt-E-D-R, and then all of the blank rows, there were two blank rows for every page, are down there at the bottom. We can just delete all of those, Alt-E-D-R, and then because we added the sequence in with the sequencer, simple matter of clicking A to Z, and the headings come back up to the top where they belong. All the data is in the original sequence, and we have a nice data set now that we can pivot or, you know, whatever. So great little bit of code there. Thanks to Jim Simons for passing that along. He says he learned this code in my class.
Mr. Excel's got bills like you. Here's the product placement you gotta zip through.
Which I guess is a shameless plug for my live lessons VBA Excel macros and VBA course from Q. Now, two other notes that we got yesterday. If you remember yesterday's episode 1907, the question there was to enter a number up in row 1 and have the numbers 1 through 15 appear. And we used this formula in the podcast, but then I also showed where we could select several cells and run a macro. Bob Umlis, my good friend and fellow Excel MVP, came along and pointed out that my macro had two loops, an outer loop for each cell in selection, and then I looped to add the numbers in. He says those three lines can all just be one line. So from the cell, go down one row, resize to the value in the cell, and then use evaluate. So what does this do? This says, hey, we're going to build a cell reference 1:10 or 12, 1:12. Take the row of all of that, evaluate that, and send it back into those cells. And sure enough, that macro works really well. So I'll do Alt F8 and expand numbers Bob, click run, and in one fell swoop, it just adds those numbers in. And then finally, in a comment at YouTube, Brian Crosby said it would be better if, rather than just using my macro, we set up an event handler macro to fire whenever the cell changes up there in row 1. But he pointed out, in case we went to a smaller number, like from 12 to 6, it would have to clear all the cells below in case we put a smaller number in. So let's go back to VBA, Alt F11. This event handler is actually entered on the worksheet, so it's not in a module 1. I'm going to double click on the Brian sheet, choose worksheet from the top left, change from the top right. And then a simple little macro here, instead of cell, as Bob gave us, it's a variable called target. That's what Excel gives us. So if target.row is equal to 1, we have to turn off the event handler. That's very important. And then clear, I just cleared the next 500 cells. I suppose I could have just done end Excel down. And then from the target, go down one row. This is Bob's line of code, just modified to use target instead of cell. Finally turn the event handler back on. So let's check out Brian's code here. Anytime I come up to row 1 and type something, 15, it fills in the numbers. If I type a smaller number, 10, it clears everything before filling them in. So just a cool little bit of code there. 2 days now on filling cells. I really like the Jim Simon sequencer code. This will become part of my repertoire. You can add it to your personal macro workbook. And anytime you need to add a sequence of numbers, it will continue to work. So thanks to Jim Simons, Bob Umless, Brian Crosby, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.